Hey everyone, Dr. Buzzkill here. I'm not as jazzed or pumped about the periodic table's four new elements as everyone else seems to be. Stick around to find out why, and why these four may be the last ones we see added to the table for quite a while. Here's the thing. These new elements are actually old news. Scientists created elements 113, 115, 117, and 118 years ago. They've even had placeholders on the periodic table with temporary names. They're making news now because IUPAC, the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, is officially adding them to the periodic table. You might be wondering what took them so long. Well, the periodic table is a pretty big deal, so IUPAC needs to vet any new addition. That's their prerogative. I'll give you a second to fully appreciate that sick Bobby Brown reference. The experiments performed to create and verify elements are tough. There are only a few labs on the planet that can handle them. In a typical experiment, researchers fire a beam of atoms like calcium or zinc into a target made from a different type of atom, say bismuth or berkelium. If all goes well, these atoms fuse to create brand new superheavy atoms. The problem is these experiments yield only a few atoms of the new element, and those atoms don't stick around for long. We're talking seconds to less than a millisecond. They rapidly decay into lighter elements, so researchers have to work backward from those lighter elements to convince everyone that what they started with was, in fact, the new element. They then need to do more experiments to confirm the creation of the new element, and then, I presume, watch the fifth element. And this all takes a while. Right now, no one's had any success creating an element heavier than 118, so it will probably be years, if not decades, before we see any more elements added to the periodic table. Listen to me, getting all worked up. Maybe I am kind of jazzed. And there really is a lot to geek out about here. For example, the seventh row of the periodic table is now officially full, and it should only be a few months before the new elements get their official names and abbreviations. The naming is up to the people who discover the elements in IUPAC, but that shouldn't stand in the way of some good old-fashioned lobbying. We, and many others, think that there should be more elements named after women. They're responsible for a lot of important nuclear chemistry and, you know, science in general. Right now, there are only two elements named after women. Well, more like one and a half because Marie has to share curium with Pierre. So we want to hear your suggestions. What would you name the new elements? Share your ideas in the comments below and we'll give our favorites a shout out in our next video. Oh hey, speaking of that, did you notice something different about this video? That's because we've officially joined the reactions team. What does that mean? More awesome chemistry for you. We'll be trying out some new projects and we're totally psyched about them, so be sure to hit subscribe to catch them all. Like chemistry Pokemon.